Hey there, welcome to my YouTube channel, Living in Tallahassee, Florida. I try to put videos out on a regular basis to keep you up to date on what's going on in the Tallahassee, Florida market. We learn how to things to do and play and where to go to school and eat and how to buy real estate here as well. So this week's video is more about the market updates, some of the things that are taking place. I did one of these back in about May of this year, 2023. This one's up for July of 2023. Quite a few changes, so stay tuned. Let's get started right now. Ba-boom. So welcome back again to my YouTube channel, Living in Tallahassee, Florida. My name is Jeff Ragan. I am the owner and the broker of Friendly Real Estate Group, and we are a group of real estate agents that work hard to help people find homes and to get to know our lovely city. So I wanted to bring you an update of what's going on in our current market as of July 2023. So there's a lot going on, and I just wanted to share these things with you. So let's jump right into it. I'm going to go ahead and do a screenshot here, and in the screenshot I'll show you some of the graphics that I think you'll find extremely interesting. So let's get started with that right now. Okay, to begin our update for Leon County, Florida real estate market, we're going to take what I call the 30,000 foot view. So I'm going to identify for you just some of the market trends that we currently have in this market. And this is for single family homes only. And this is for a report for the month of July of 2023. So I want you to look at the market type. You notice here that the blue bar right underneath the word market type is what's considered a seller's market. And then the lighter blue in the middle is a balanced market. And then the orange over here is a buyer's market. And as you can see, with the triangle kind of in the orange here, we are more in a buyer's market than what we were, say, several months ago. Is basically a seller's market for several years in a row. So kind of getting the key details that we're mostly interested in here, I want you to notice that the key details that we're going to look at here is months of inventory. This is a especially interesting statistic, because what this means is that it would take right now 7.85 months to sell all the properties off, given these numbers, these stats, without adding any new inventory to the market. However, this is a drop of 1.75% month over month. I like to watch this very closely because it really tells us a lot about what type of market we're in. And the way that that's figured is a seller's market is considered when there is less than 5.5 months of inventory to be sold. A balanced market is when there is less or greater than 5.6 months and less than 6.5 months of inventory. And then a buyer's market is considered that when there is more or greater than 6.6 months of inventory. And this is updated on a monthly basis. So as you can see, right now we are in a buyer's market. So it means the sellers are a little more negotiable. And you'll see as I look at some of the other statistics as far as how you can get a better transaction. We like to watch the list to sold price percent. Even though it's at 99.5%, what this means is that people aren't getting the prices that they were asking. They list it, let's say, for $300,000, but they're not getting $300,000. They're getting a half a percent lower. This is a drop, though. It's a decrease of 0.02% month over month. So for comparing June to July, it's a little bit of a decrease. Median days on the market is now 41 days. That is an increase of 2.5% of month over month. So it's taking a little bit longer to sell a property in our market right now. Median sold price, we see a price here of $335,750. This is especially interesting to me because it is a drop from the month of June of 6.74% month over month. So in other words, they are getting a lot less money, 6.74% price decreases, which is really what we need to see. We need to see the home prices come down. We'd like to see interest rates come down because we just are not in a very affordable market. But you hear a lot of people say there's just not enough inventory. Well, right now here in this Tallahassee market, we've got inventory. And it's actually getting lower in price, and it's taking longer to sell, making sellers a little bit more negotiable. Let's move to the next section. Okay, so this is a kind of a secondary 30,000 foot view. You'll notice this is for the median estimated property value. However, this is for the month of August of 2023. And what this really means is this graph is actually displaying estimates, as you see here, for a market area and a subject property where one has been selected. These are not formal appraisals, okay? So it just gives us an idea. And as all the other stats, it's updated monthly. So looking here at the median estimated value. Now, these are estimated values. Some people like to call things Zestimates. Well, forget the Zestimates. They're very inaccurate. This is going to be far more accurate because it's based on statistics in the MLS. Zillow, with their Zestimates, trust me, it's not reliable. So looking at this currently then, we can see that the median estimated value is $338,180. So that's currently here in our real estate market in Tallahassee, Florida. Again, single family homes, it is an increase over the previous month of 0.9%, almost one full percentage point. So property values are still going up, and you see the 12-month change of 4.1%. So this graph down below here is an estimate. It's all put into a graph for you. And as you can see, the values are changing. Now, there's different colors here. Leon County is the blue one. And so these numbers that are at the top of the screen represent Leon County. If you look at the actual yellow line, that's for the USA. And then the state of Florida itself is the orange line, the top line. So Leon County has the lowest priced real estate in the state of Florida, and it's lower priced than actually what you would find on average in the rest of the US as far as median estimated values. So that's an interesting statistic, and it's a no wonder. I'm talking to people from other countries. I'm talking to people from several different states, and even people from the state of Florida itself in South Florida that are moving up here to North Florida, where Leon County has cheaper real estate. So that's a couple of quick looks at some of what I would call the 30,000 foot view. Let's move to the next section. All right, so now we're gonna move into and talk about new listings. Once again, we're talking only about single family homes. We're looking at new listings that come onto the market for the month, and this is statistics for the month of July of 2023. So what this data gives us is it actually summarizes key statistics for properties that entered the market each month. And so we use the list date to determine when a listing is entered into the market. They're important for understanding the rate at which listings are entering the market and their price points. So beginning with, again, the median list price. Median list price is $359,900. And these are the new listings that enter the market here in Leon County, Florida. This is up 1.4% month over month. So we are kind of going the other direction. Prices are going up a little bit, as you can see. As far as the number of properties, there was 347 properties that actually are on the market. This is down 6% from month over month. You see how the graph below displays these figures. So you can see technically how our market kind of bounces up and down quite a bit. But from back, it's only charting back to July of 2018, but we can see that we're basically still have less homes on the market for for several months. There was a little dip in December, which is seasonal. It always happens because of the holidays. The median square foot is $207. That is an increase of 3.5% month over month. And as you can see by the graph, once again, we have constantly gone up. This is the cost per square foot of a home from a median standpoint. The total dollar volume, which is not important to you, but you can see that the total dollar volume is 150 million plus. And the median living area is actually 1,800 square feet. That is down 0.1% month over month. And you're going to see that happen. As prices go up, the builders are building smaller houses. So they want to maintain those profit margins, which is understandable. But you're going to see the prices of, the square foot of homes begin to shrink. They're going to get a little bit smaller. So let's move to the next portion of our report. So again, now we're going to look at what we would call the active listings in Leon County. And what this means is it's a summarizing of the key statistics that were active in an active status on the last day of each month. In other words, they were available to be purchased. So it's just the end of the month snapshot, so to speak. Once again, when it comes to active listings during the month of July of 2023 for single family homes, the median list price was $389,500, up 2.6% month over month. As you can see in the graph here, the median list price has continually climbed there up until about, it looks like about April of 2022. Well, it kept going, So about July of 2022, it began to level off. As you can see, it's kind of gone up and down, but it's leveled off. So we now see the median list price a little bit lower, but still month over month is a little on the higher side. The number of actual properties that were available, 676, that's down 2.5% month over month. So again, looking at the chart, you can see that the active listings is actually continuing to decline. So yes, our inventory is still a little bit tight, however, things seem to be changing. Median days on the market, 37 days. Look at that increase of 19.4% month over month. So it's taking longer to sell houses, as you can see here in this chart. The median dollar per square foot, $207. That's up 1% month over month. Once again, you can see the constant increase has been going on, especially since COVID. You see that meteoric rise. Dollar volume is at 300 million plus, down 2.8%. Median living area square feet, 1,835, which is down 1.9% month over month. Now let's move to some of our latter reports. So now we'll move to what we will refer to as the pending listings. So very simply what this means, these are the homes that actually went pending during the month. For example, on the last day of the month, this was the number of homes that actually were in pending status. So looking again at median list price, $339 was the median list price, again down 4.6% month over month. You can see in the graph below how list prices have gone down. Way back in December or November of 2022, list prices were at $510,000. You can see how the prices of homes have continued to drop. These are the pending listings, and now here we are down at the $339,000. The number of properties that went pending, and again, this is for the month of July of 2023, is 95 properties that went listing during this month. 7.8% month over month drop. So again, less properties went pending during the month of July as versus the month of June. Median days on the market, this is interesting once again. You see the median days is 36. It's an increase of 28.6% month over month. And as you can see, The median days on the market fluctuates. Of course, December is pretty traditional, being less properties selling than that. But you can see how there was it was 70 days on the market in December of 2022, and here we are now. We're back. We bottomed out around May of 2023, and now it's headed back up. It's taken a little bit longer. Properties are on the market a little bit longer. Median dollar per square foot, $218. You can see it's still kind of up there. It's gone up certainly from back during the COVID days. As you can see, COVID was back in here. There's COVID, February of 2020, $151 per square foot. And now here we are ending the month of July at $218. This is what I thought was an interesting statistic. Once again, the median living area square foot, 1,680, down 4.9% month over month. Remember, I was talking earlier that the homes are getting smaller, and that's exactly what's happening. You can see the square foot dropping off, especially since, you know, basically you can see it from March of 2022 down to where we're at today. So just some interesting statistics once again that helps you understand a little bit more about our real estate market here in Tallahassee, Florida. Okay, so the last little bit of data I'm going to share with you now is the sold listings. This is what really where I would say the rubber meets the road. So a sold listing is obviously a property that actually sold during the month. You know, this is the number of properties that have sold during the month. And so it was moved into a sold status within this given month. In this case, we're still again in the month of July of 2023, single family homes only. So the median sold price, as you can see, during the month of July was $335,750. That is down 6.7% month over month. And you can see the chart here once again, you know, as properties, the sold prices was continually to increase, starting to dip off a little bit here. The number of properties, 228 properties, that's a 13.3% decrease month over month. The average sold, or the average list to sale price, it was 99.47%, basically flat from the month previous month of June. Days on the market, as we can see, it's increased to 41 days on the market, a 2.5% increase month over month. Median dollar per square foot, $198, down 2% month over month. And as you can see, even though they've been increasing, it's starting to taper off. So what does all of this mean to you? Well, basically what I want you to think about is this is just data that can help you get an idea as to where we're at in the real estate market here in Tallahassee, Florida. I would love to be your realtor. You can reach out to me. All of my contact information is down in the description below. I would be happy to have a Zoom meeting with you. We could discuss what your exact needs are. Once I know your criteria, I can set up a search for you in what we call our collaboration center, which is a live feed to our MLS, better than Zillow and Realtor.com or any of those things. And also, it gives you an opportunity to find out how quickly properties sell and what types are selling, and you can do little comparisons and so forth. So my name is Jeff Ragan. I'm the owner and the broker of the Friendly Real Estate Group. I'd love to be your realtor the next time. So all you need to do is to reach out to me and let me know how I can be of assistance to you. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.